Hello, my name is Kathryn, and I'm here with Wai-Ling and with Yilin, and we are going to do a reading of a poem I wrote and Yilin and Wai-Ling translated. It's called Dragons Might Have Been Here. And this poem appears in Living Hyphen's issue, Resistance Across Generations. And we're going to do a reading for you in three languages. I'll read in English, and then Yilin in Mandarin, and then Wai-Ling will read in Cantonese. Dragons might have been here once, but we would never know, because the footprints that they might have left are covered by the snow. This is a poem for the train tracks. This is a poem for the broken bones. This is a poem for the broken backs that line the Fraser River bed. Under every foot of track in the Fraser River Valley lies the body of one Chinese railroad worker. This is a poem for the train tracks built on the backs of mountains, for the train tracks built to build a nation, for the train tracks built to build a dream. For the tracks that splintered spines of rocks, for the tracks that splintered spines of Chinamen, for the train tracks built on the backs of coolies, this is a poem for the train tracks. For the train tracks built on the broken backs, for the broken bones, for the bones snapped like chopsticks. This is a poem for the bones that never made it home. This is a poem for the heads taxed, for the yellow bodies less than white, for those with less than equal rights. This is a poem for the lines laid on the backs of coolies, for the stories that line the faces of the grandparents who won't speak to save face. Though they face the seas, they face the mountains, they face the wars, their faces will still never appear on the faces of our $5 bills. This is a poem for the ties that bind, the ties that break our feet, our backs, our spines, our spirits. For we are the load. We are like railroad ties laid out in parallel lines, invisible lines that stop us from seeing that collectively we are the track that bears the load of each passing train. That we are the track that underlies this economy, this society where the undesirable work has long been done by the undesirables, where the skeletons of our cities are shades darker than the faces in our boardrooms. And these race lines, these power lines, these rail lines are the cracks in the foundations of this nation's heritage. In that Canadian heritage moment, the last spike, they're all white. And out of sight and out of mind and in the back are the Chinamen, the silent spikes, who broke their backs for these rail lines. Now this selective amnesia makes for collective amnesia, makes us internalize invisible lies, lies that we have learned by heart, by skin, by bone, lies that tell us that we are not at home here, lies that tell us we do not have a stake in any of this, when these train tracks would not exist were it not for the backs of Chinamen. So this is a poem for the silent spikes whose stories weren't shared, whose shame kept them silent, whose strength kept them silent, whose pride kept them silent, whose hope that the future would be different kept them silent. This is an offering. Dragons might have been here once, I'll tell you how we know, because their footprints that they left are where the wild flowers grow.
这里可能有过巨龙，但是我们将永远无法确定，因为他们可能留下过的脚印早已被雪覆盖。 这首诗是为高山的铁轨而写，这首诗是为无数的断背而写，这首诗是为成千上万的断肢而写。他们埋没于 Fraser River 的河床，穿梭 Fraser River 的铁路，每一英尺下面都埋着一位华工的尸体。这首诗是为建造在 高山砌背上的火车轨道而写，写给为修建国家而建的轨道，那些为缔造梦想而建的轨道，写给砸碎巨石的砌筑的轨道，写给砸碎华工的砌骨的轨道，写给建造在汗流浃背的华工上的轨道。 这首诗是为火车轨道而写，写给建造在无数去骨折上的火车轨道。这首诗是为无数的骨折而写。 如同筷子般的骨折。这首诗是为永远留在异国他乡的尸骨而写。这首诗是为交过人头税的人而写，写给被认为不如白人的黄种人，写给那些不拥有平等权利的人。这首诗是为华工背上的无数的伤痕线而写，写给祖父母上有故事的皱纹线，他们因为不愿丢脸而选择沉默。他们面对过大海洋，面对过苍山峻岭，面对战争火炮炮火，他们的面目永远不会出现在五元钞票上。这首诗是为了密不可分的关系而写，为了那些让祖怀、气吹、骨气、灵魂破损的关系而写。我们就如密不可分的轨道，蔓延的平行线，无形的线，让我们没有察觉到，作为集体，我们就是轨道，承载着每一班火车的重量，我们就是轨道，支撑着国家经济的下沉。在这里，被嫌弃的工作，一直都靠被嫌弃的人完成。在这里，城市中的尸骨的颜色，比董事们的脸还黑暗。这些民族界限，这些权柄界限，这些铁路界限，就是这个国家历史根底的裂痕，在加拿大民族历史时刻最后的一颗钉图片中，所有人都是白种人，而那些看不见不用考虑的正在背后的华工，默默无言的钉子，为了这些铁轨而砌筑骨折，选择性的失忆促使集体的失忆，促使我们吸收无形的谎话，那些渗透着我们的心脏、皮肤、头骨的谎言。谎言告诉我们这不是我们的国家，谎言告诉我们我们与铁路没有一丁点关系。但这些轨道的存在建立在华工的汗流浃背上。这首诗是为那些默默无言的钉子而写，他们的故事没有被分享，他们的耻辱使他们沉默，他们的自尊使他们沉默，他们的力量使他们沉默，他们对未来的憧憬使他们沉默。这是献给他们的。这里可能有过巨龙，让我告诉大家，我们怎么才能知道？他们曾经留下的那些脚印，就是如今野花绽放的地方。
这里可能有过巨龙，这里可能有过巨龙，但是我们将永远无法确定，因为他们可能留下过的脚印早已被雪覆盖。这首诗是为高山的铁轨而写，这首诗是为无数的断背而写，这首诗是为成千上万的断肢而写。他们埋没在 Fraser River 的河床，穿梭 Fraser Valley 的铁路，每一英尺下面都埋着一位华工的尸体。这首诗是为建造在高山脊背上的火车铁轨而写，写建修建国家而建的轨道，那些为缔造梦想而建的轨道，写给炸碎巨石的脊柱的轨道，写给炸碎华工的脊骨的轨道，写给建造在汗流浃背的华工上的轨道。这首诗是为火车轨道而写，写给建造在无数脊柱骨折上的火车轨道。这首诗是为无数的骨折而写，如同筷子般的骨折。这首诗是为永远留在异国他乡的尸骨而写，这首诗是为交过人头税的人而写， 写给被认为不如白种人的黄种人，写给那些不拥有平等权利的人。这首诗是为华工背上无数的伤痕先而写，写给祖父母脸上有故事的皱纹线，他们因为不愿丢脸而选择沉默，他们面对过大海洋，面对过崇山峻岭，面对过战争炮火，他们的面目永远不会出现在五元钞票上。这首诗是为了密不可分的关系而写，为了那些让烛火、脊椎、骨气、灵魂破损的关系而写。我们就如密不可分的轨道，蔓延的平衡线，无形的线，让我们没有察觉到。作为集体，我们就是轨道，承载着每一班火车的重量。我们就是轨道，支撑着国家经济的下沉。在这里，被嫌弃的工作一直都靠被嫌弃的人完成。在这里，城市中的尸骨的颜色比董事们的脸还要黑暗。这些民族界线，这些权柄界线，这些铁轨路线，这是这个国家历史根底的裂痕，在加拿大民族历史时刻，最后的一果钉。图片中所有的人都是白种人，而那些看不见、不用考虑的、站在背后的华工，默默无言的钉子，为了这些铁轨而脊柱骨折，选择性的失忆，促使集体的失忆，促使我们吸收无形的谎话，那些渗透着我们心脏、皮肤、骨头的谎言，谎言告诉我们，这不是我们的家园。谎言告诉我们，我们与铁路没有一丁点的关系，但这些轨道的存在建立在华工的汗流浃背上。这首诗是为那些默默无言的钉子而写，他们的故事没有被分享，他们的耻辱使他们沉默，他们的自尊使他们沉默，他们的良使他们沉默，他们对未来的憧憬使他们沉默，这是献给他们的。这里可能有过巨龙，让我告诉大家，我们怎么能确知他们曾经留下的那些脚印，就是如今野花殿放的地方。
So yeah, we just wanted to tell you a little bit about this poem and the process behind it and how we ended up with this poem in three languages. So I originally wrote this poem in English and started a project to translate some of my poetry into Chinese, into Cantonese, which is my mother's mother tongue. And then along the way, we were so lucky to meet Yilin, who is an amazing translator, editor, poet themselves, and helped us out with the Mandarin translation, or the translation in general. So I'm just going to see if Yilin and Wai-Ling want to share a little bit about the translation process.
Well, I was just very excited about the poem. Years ago when Kathryn finished writing, I was kind of playing around with it, trying to translate it into Chinese and see how it looks like. And then later on, we have the honor to team up with Yilin, and then we kind of like discuss a lot of how to wordsmith the poem. Mm-hmm. And I think the poem is very powerful. And I got emotional every time when I read it. Yeah, because I like it so much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is such a powerful poem. And thank you so much, Kathryn and Wai-Ling, for inviting me on to work with you, because it's such a powerful tribute, you know, to all the Chinese Canadians who were involved in building the railway, and to be able to help translate it and to hear it performed in Xi languages is very powerful, because it brings to life, I think, some of the different voices in the poem.
That's beautiful. I love that. I think it's so, I love hearing how I feel like there's just a different mood that's created in each language. Like I love how you put that, though, that there's different voices because they're contributing to the same story. But yeah, I just love how, like, getting the chance to appreciate, like, the rhythm and the musicality of the different languages is something really, really cool about this process.